I've come today to Whitchurch, where an invisible killer remains at large. Nearly 1 in 10 people here are victims. The killer, asthma. Unknown to the local residents, Shropshire boasts nationally high levels of ammonia gas, which has been linked to asthma in children. But the effects aren't limited to our towns. Our countryside is falling victim too. The Shropshire Wildlife Trust have been investigating the impacts felt here at Wixall Moss, where atmospheric pollution has been eutrophying this normally nutrient-poor environment. Sundew is a perfect indicator for this. Normally carnivorous, they've stopped catching insects for nutrition because of ammonia pollution, a sign of wider changes to this fragile ecosystem. So where is all of this ammonia pollution coming from? In Shropshire, around 90% is from agriculture. Within Shropshire, poultry and pig units like this one here are collectively amongst the worst offenders and have been popping up across the county in recent years. British farming is vital to our food security and is an important element in our strategy to tackle global climate change. The Shropshire Wildlife Trust recognises that stopping our local producers isn't the answer. Instead, we need to focus on providing our farmers with the solutions they need.
For pigs, amino acids are essential for high performance, but oversupplying these acids causes nitrogen loss. Cutting the protein in a pig's diet by 1% can reduce the animal ammonia production by up to 10%. And due to the high cost of this protein, it can save farmers up to £5 per tonne of feed. Acid scrubbers or biotrickling filters enhance forced air systems. They work in low pH environments by reacting ammonia with acids to produce a leachate that can be safely drained away. Whilst the cost can be over £1 per pig produced, they are highly effective, removing up to 90% of the ammonia.
If enough farmers implement these measures, atmospheric pollution will drop countywide, and the children of Whitchurch can breathe safely once again. From all of us here at the Shropshire Wildlife Trust, goodbye.